So my name is Christian Traholt, the first author up here. That's the point. Yeah. Okay. And I'm from the DTU Electro, or the Electrical Engineering Department here at DTU. And my colleagues are Joachim Holbøl, Ole Thomsen, Claus Kærgaard, all associate professors here. And then I acknowledge the workshop and one of our PhD students who helped with a few of the pictures. I'm going to speak about the steam engine powering the electric grid today. And it's a fourth semester course, so after 2 years or 1.5 years, they'll be working with this, integrating whatever they have learned on up till then. I would like to introduce with the sort of giving a short overview of the framework we are working within, and then just present the idea, and then list the objectives, and then try to illustrate what means we use in order to promote the teaching to the students, and then just a slide or two with the results. So the framework here at DTU is that there's an old course that needed to be sort of, well, I don't know, it shows converted into the CDIO format, and it is a sort of a rigid course with three main elements. You need to know something about the electric power grid, something about power electronics, and then you have a fixed 3 week period at the end of the course, which is for project work. And it's built up with traditional stop tests and exams and sort of calculus exercises and lab exercises. So in our new course, we introduce also an element of project management and an element of control that is integrated with a parallel course working with control. And then we also try to integrate the physics and thermodynamics and other techniques that the students have acquired up till then. And then also the timing of it is not with sort of stop test, and there's no fixed 3 weeks period at the end to do the product work. And then we work with we have from external that we have to work in groups, but we have to evaluate each student individually. So that's quite a challenge. And we have a budget of, actually that's per exercise, so we have 5 exercises, so it's 5 times this for the whole project. Please correct me, Klaus, if there's anything wrong. And we have 50 over students, and we group them in groups with 10 to 12 students in each group. And then we would like to use this exercise again the next year. So I'd color-coded this, so it should be a little bit easier to follow it later on. So the idea is this, at least every boy, but probably also today, most girls know this from their childhood. You play around with a steam engine. Here is a two-cylindered one, and that's actually the heavy post on the cost. This is buying this one. So this is our starting point. So we rebuild it, and here's sort of the basic system, and then we control it with the cheapest and most cost-effective I/O box from National Instruments. And if we take sort of an overview, so top-down view of it, then we have the boiler here, and we have substitute the Floyde, the whistle with the entrance for pumping in the water. Otherwise, this will only run for maybe 5 or 10 minutes. And we want them to obtain a constant mode of, say, 100 or 150 hertz. So if they have to stop every 5 or 10 minutes, it's difficult to control the system like that. So now they can pump in water continuously. And then we have substituted the pressure sensor, an analog one with a digital, or at least a sensor which gives digital signals out. And we can provide heat through PWM modulation of 230 volts, so about 1,000 watts. And it's controlled by this relay. And we have a booster board that boosts the signal from this, because this is only USB driven. So we can connect it directly to any laptop, but you don't have enough power to run the relays and so on. So we need sort of a booster board here. So we have a controllable valve with a tacho, and we have the cylinders here, mechanical transmission here, the three-phase generator here, and here are three single-phase ring transformers, so they're reasonable efficient transformers. And the overall efficiency from here to there is about 1 to 1,000. So we put in about 1,000 watts here, and we get out about 1 watt here. And then they are supposed to build on with this to this one with power electronics, controls, and modification, whatever they think is that's up to the students. So what are the learning objectives here? So we have all the sort of power electronic, the electric power engineering, so the grid relevant learning up here. And then we have the power electronics here. And we have project management and group work. We have, evaluation and so on down here. And we have some analysis and problem definition down here also. So these are the objectives. So these are sort of the hard objectives with the sort of the professional skills in hard terms. And here we have the sort of more management related skills. So schematics I place in. So overall we have the management skills and the project work. And in sort of the boiler and sort of the board, the basic system is like makes up the thermodynamics, the physics, and whatever they have sort of learned until now. We have to start like with a basic system, because we believe that if you start all the way from scratch, you will never reach to, or it will be difficult to reach to the stage where they start to learn really about three-phase transformers, reactive power, etc., etc. And so that's why we sort of start out with this part almost built. They can reconfigure it in many ways. They can build additions on it. They can, and I'll show a few examples of it afterwards. So if we take the learning objectives, so we can sort of group them into the general skills with the CIO syllabus. And into the syllabus one with all the technical skills they sort of provided here. This is actually taken from your paper, so I hope it's correct. You can add to this, then it's okay. Anyway, so this illustrates sort of how did we do it. So we still have the 13 weeks to work with, and then the extra 3 weeks just before summer. Actually, right at this moment, they are concluding their work, and we are going to have poster presentation at this coming Friday in 2 days. And so that's why I'm not here so much either. But we did it this way, not to sort of so that everyone can sort of understand and be part of it, also for the a little bit more traditional teachers. So actually we do like this. We say we offer students these lectures on electrical engineering and power electronics. They are optional, but strongly recommended. There are some, we provide them with some calculus exercises and lab exercises, which are also optional, but which they can use, they can solve them, and they can use them as documentation on what they have learned and And then we provide them with lectures on project management, on how to divide things into group. And down here, we also provide them with how to disseminate your or to present your work. How do you want to communicate it to people? So all this is optional, but it's highly recommended to follow it. And there's no stop test anymore, but there are compulsory self-evaluations. And the first one comes after a few weeks. And then we inform the students that we'll have focus on how did they tackle the problem, how do they divide the problems into subtasks, and how do they manage them, what are their own timelines for doing this and the project. This is our focus here. But they can also self-evaluate or self-document what they have obtained within the other groups also. But our focus will be here in order to be able to feed back to them on how well are their group running. Do we think they need more specifics on the task and milestones, or is it okay? And on the second compulsory evaluation, we focus on the technical part. So what are their documentation on the learnings for power engineering and power electronics? And in the last evaluation, they have to include everything, but at the same time, we also see how do they present their stuff, how is their poster presenting itself, and how well does their system work, and what kind of innovation do they have they added to the system. And then also we have a visit to a relevant power plant, so they can actually compare that this power plant is similar to the real one, lacking maybe a few elements like for control, which is on the big one. The real power plant would be much more complex than this one. Here I have divided the things, the syllables or the technical knowledge into the different regions, color-coded. And I think it's more or less speaks for itself. I won't repeat this. I think I will go to the results. So what are the results? Well, there have been a lot of hard work and understanding for the students. They have learned, delta Y configurations of the transformers and all the technical stuff that is included here. This is sort of just a placeholder. They have learned about control strategies, PID control, and so on. They have built, maybe some of them have built automatic filling using Lego motors controlling it. Some of them have looked into level meters, so they can either look from outside into the boiler and optically see what where's the water level. Others have dismantled, opened it, put in a capacitive level meter. There are different solutions for the power electronics. Someone come up with a chip that does everything. Others build them with discrete elements or discrete components. Someone try to add solar cells like this one. So the steam engine will provide about 1 watt, and this is in the same order of magnitude. So if you can put this one on with synchronizing to the frequency and so on, this is just a normal charger for your telephone. And so I think they have sort of more or less worked within all the CDIO elements from conceived to finished functional model. And they earn that 10 credits, the ones who pass it. And student evaluation is ongoing, so I can't give you the results on this. And it has also inspired us to build a hydroelectric system with sort of like 1 cubic meter of water and an elevation difference of 10 meters. So there's a master group running this, which is very similar to what we have done. And this poster is how it would be presented. So each two or three people have to make something like an A4 piece, and it has to be individual distinguishable, but also we should be able to see it as one big integrated poster. And this poster was actually presented over here and at Tuesday at 4 or 3 o'clock. So some of you might have seen it. This is what I had to say.